Let's give this a buddy go, right? This is Bird Island, or Bird Isle, I think it's called. Around the corner we've got Penguin Island, and then Seal Isle. Got a shark just to the left of us, just saw a fin popping out. And a little one. And the wind's coming. On the nose of the bow now, which is from about the southwest. We're paddling a K1 out in the ocean. This K1 has got a bit of extra buoyancy in the nose. Makes it shed that extra bit of water and pop out of the waves. Not many people paddle a K1 in the ocean. Probably with good reason. We're in the shelter of a sandbank. We'll be out of it before you know it. Then things will be a little bit more interesting. Not too interesting, I hope. Catch one of these waves. Over a sandbank to the other side. About 15 knots at the moment. South African K1, going to Penguin Island. A little bit of a front out there. Hopefully it doesn't blow too hard. Don't forget in the shelter of the island before it starts. Doing it easy at the moment. Island in Western Australia, just off of Rockingham or Lakey Bay. Beautiful little place. You're playing with stability. Place to play on a K1, a nice K1. Normally I come out here with the Jaguar. Jaguar K1. But this one, I've forgotten the name of it. It's very much like a Cleaver Mac. Beautiful boat to paddle in the ocean. On a nice day. Probably not a great boat to paddle. It's in between. Guess what I love. We've come from Warmbra Sound. From the edge of Waikiki. Come along the beach. Turn the on, I hope. At Bird Island. Bird Isle. Gotta admit, compared to the Jaguar, this is like a barge. She runs beautifully. Stable. Marathon boat weight. Just 12 kilos. fringe boat, weighs 8 kilos. Regulation weight, regulation length. Beautiful paddling, beautiful paddling. If you can paddle a K1, it doesn't get any better than this. Unless you're coming first in a race, and you just feel like shit. And feel good at the same time. Calmer than yesterday. Yesterday we had breaking waves over us the whole way. Swell starting to come in. Okay. Beautiful swells yesterday, you could surf all the way in. This is Penguin Island over here to our right. Well, it's nesting on there at the moment in the middle of winter. Just here on our right, we've got a reef which is out of the water some of the time. In the ocean now, right in the ocean, on the outside of the island. A little bit choppy, but it's not bad. Breeze here is about 12 knots. Quite pleasant. A bit stirred up. Reefs. The swells. Not bad. Been a lot worse. But maybe not in a K1. We've got a spray deck, so we should be alright. Get a bit bloody wet. The idea here is not swim. This gets a bit tricky because we're going to go side on to the seas and swell. Sun straight in our face. started zigzagging. Oh, ride those big swells, baby. Bit tricky, a little bit technical. Probably won't have good balance to do this. Have the odd brace stroke, or it's going to be breast stroke. Big swell. There's the island there, in front of us, on the outside of the island. All the breakers in front. The idea is not to kill yourself, because you want to stay strong when you need it. When you need those reflexes. Going sideways to the swell can be tricky, but doable. And that's over there in front of us is Seal Island. We're not going around there, we'll go between Seal and Penguin Island and then head off back. Hopefully we've got some footage. No, we'll come and do it again. Bit of a brace strike with a paddle cord under, a bit of brake and swell. Circumnavigated Penguin Island almost. Still on the outside. Still working. big break and swells just outside of us. Big break and swells just inside of us with a reef. Massive big swells coming through. Now we've got to sort of like navigate between the swells and the reefs. And here she can be really tricky. I think I've got to go outside of these two swells. Again. At the moment, takes a lot of concentration, ride these big swells.